Imam of the military base, Imam al-Askari alayhi salam. Born in Medina, the 11th Imam of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam, Hassan ibn Ali, son of Imam al-Hadi alayhi salam and Lady Sawsan alayhi salam. He became known as al-Askari, the one who lived his life in a garrison town when his family were forced to leave Medina for Samarra. He spent his life from childhood to adulthood under house arrest, yet still conducted his duties as an Imam of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam. He taught the Quran through penning a tafsir and through his kindness to others. One time, one of his Shias bought him the ripest of pomegranates, and the Imam alayhi salam gave to them to the hungry guard, keeping him prisoner. Yet despite his good nature, he was made to suffer so much. Banu Abbas was always looking for ways to abuse and humiliate Imam al-Askari alayhi salam. One time, they bought a wild, untamed horse and threw every rider that sat on its back and ordered the Imam to ride it. No sooner had the hand of Imam Hassan al-Askari stroked his neck, the horse became tame. One of his guards took him to his house and put him in a garden with wild beasts, hoping the Imam would get killed. When the guard looked out of the window, he saw the beasts prostrating beside the Imam. Imam al-Askari alayhi salam saved Islam when a severe drought overtook the land. The people were confused because every time a Christian priest would pray, water would fall down from the sky. As they began to doubt Islam, Imam al-Askari alayhi salam was released from prison and told the people to look at what the Christian was holding. He was holding the bone of a prophet, and that is why the rain fell. Imam al-Askari alayhi salam then prayed two rak'ats and raised his hands to the skies. Sweet fresh water came down from the heavens and the people began to rejoice. He married Lady Narjis alayhi salam, a former princess of Rome, and from this blessed union came the Imam of our age, ajallahu farjahu sharif. The life of Imam al-Askari alayhi salam was short thanks to the jealousy of Banu Abbas. His fruit was poisoned and the Imam was martyred in his home. He was buried beside his father, and his shrine now has the largest golden dome in the world. Yet while he was dying, he did not think about himself. All he could think of was his grandfather Imam Hussein alayhi salam, and what it would have been like to die upon the burning ground of Karbala.